Hello, I am Tyasha Casey. My presentation will be on my internship with the NATO Innovation Hub for Class Polls 498. I will begin with some background information. And NATO is the North Atlantic Treaty Organization. It is a coalition of 30 North American and European countries. It was established in 1949 on April 4th. The NATO Innovation Hub is an organization that uses the expertise and creativity of the greater community to solve issues within NATO. When I first applied to the internship, I was asked what kind of things I was into, and I've always loved studying cultures and languages. Therefore, I was placed on the language translation project. The objective of this project was to find, test, and purchase translation software to be used for the Innovation Hub and their virtual meetings and conferences. The software could be AI-based or supported by human translators. I was on a team of five people, those five individuals being female. We represented five nations: the United States, Greece, Russia, Italy, and Romania, all together representing around eight languages. The type of translation software needed was speech to audio, where one person would speak into a mic and the other individual could hear their language spoken back to them, be it via AI or human translation. The other being speech to text or speech to closed captioning, where an individual would speak into the mic and the other person would see the translation in text, typically at the bottom of the screen, but displayed somewhere on the screen would be closed captioning translation. We had three phases for this particular project. Our first couple of meetings, we established that we would meet for a weekly tell-all meeting around once a week. Every Friday, we would have individual meetings with just our five members of the team once or twice a week. In between meetings, we would keep in contact with the companies that we were investigating, and each of us picked our own companies to reach out to and keep track of for this particular project. Unfortunately, my companies did not make it to the final, to the testing stage. But the first phase of the project was investigating various software with the capabilities that we desired. We created a list of possible options. We began contacting companies to set up demos and collect information. Phase two, we participated in the demos, and from the information collected, we began the testing of the software. We evaluated the software based on eight criteria, and we calculated the results based on a score system that we established before the testing began. We have For phase three, we are not quite ready to pick a software yet, but we will be doing that in the next week or two to wrap up the internship. We will use the results to pick the software that will best serve the purposes of the NATO Innovation Hub. Some of the companies considered from the AI category were Spiffio, Cinematic, and Wordly. From the human translator-based companies was Kudo, Interpronet, and Voiceboxer. just to give you some examples of the differences, the nomadic needs to be set up with something like Google Meet or Zoom, but it is a software that translates via AI from speech from one person to a closed caption-based translating. For Kudo is based on human translators, so they have their own meeting space where they can provide translators, or you can sign up your own translators to the system in order to facilitate your meetings. The testing process was based on 8 criteria. We asked a series of questions, some of those questions being to rate a criteria on the scale of 1 to 5, 5 being the best, 1 being the worst. Also, some questions were yes or no questions. These questions carried on a list, a set point system, which was out of 40. The criteria that we tested was platform interface, if the interface was easy to use, accessibility, whether the platform could be used by those with disabilities or could be used easily, accuracy of the translation, whether the translations were translating correctly from speech to text or from speech to speech, whether software training was offered in order to better facilitate the meeting process, if recordings or translations were offered for the meetings, affordability of the software, if it was too expensive, if it was more affordable, if the translation software had a mobile app that was also considered, and if the app translation provided closed captioning. How will the winning software be decided? Well, that will be decided by 2 factors. The testing score out of 40, which was the system that we created before testing began, and a verbal vote amongst the project members for the top 3 companies that we find with the highest scores. What will happen after the winner is decided? The team will contact the person of interest at the company, and we will begin the process to get the software for the NATO Innovation Hub. However, the final payment process and the final installation of the software will be completed by the NATO Innovation Hub. I have some acknowledgments. I would like to acknowledge Serge DeDepo at the NATO Innovation Hub. He was my leader for this project, very kind and friendly through the entire process. I would like to thank Professor Ochokoya at Virginia Wesleyan University. She kind of got me through the last 3 years in order to graduate. My research was funded by the University of Richmond through my academic scholarship. And again, the Innovation Hub for hosting this internship. This internship, I participated in finding the companies, reaching out to the companies, maintaining contact with the individuals from the companies to discuss how to go about getting the software for testing, or just asking general information about the software to proceed forward with the first phase, and also to establish whether we would continue or discontinue interactions based on how the testing went for a specific software. Also, I believe this internship helped me get more comfortable with reaching out for academic purposes or work purposes, to be more comfortable in networking and to know that I could one day reach out to a company on behalf of an organization like NATO, which was kind of interesting for me being just a college student, to have that experience and know that I can facilitate these meetings and I can just help an organization like NATO find a translation software and just be, I've learned so many things, especially just from working with the women from the other four nations and having to deal with scheduling and time zones. So I've grown and learned a lot from this internship. And I will take that knowledge with me going forward. I thank you so much for your time, and I appreciate this opportunity to work with NATO and attend Virginia Wesleyan.